Hello friends, I am Mr. Amol Yadav. Today we are going to discuss about the virtual practical on centrifugal pump. With the support and guidance of Professor Lakshman Mani and Aditya Bhavane sir. So basically the centrifugal pump is defined as a machine which driven by an external source lifts the water or other liquid from lower level to higher level. It may be also defined as a machine which converts mechanical energy into a pressure energy. Okay, so from this experiment, the learning outcome comes. So student able to understand, explain practical relevance, importance, and practical procedure of centrifugal pump. Then analysis the operating characteristics of the pump. So operating characteristics means the behavior of pump depends on the various parameters like discharge, head, efficiency, input power. Okay, now the content, this experiment, that is the theory and performance analysis of centrifugal pump, then explanation on performance of experiment, then objectives, then observations we are going to take and from the test rig, then result table we are going to calculate the various efficiencies, manometric heads, and input powers, then calculation, and then last we draw a graph on based on that result table. So objective of this experiment, study and virtual trial on centrifugal pump and plotting of operating characteristics. Now, next part, centrifugal pump test rig. So basically, I already told you, the centrifugal pump is a device to raise the liquid from lower level to higher level by creating the required pressure with the help of centrifugal action. Okay, so how the centrifugal action happen? So see this test rig. So before we discussing the procedure of this test rig, we have to know the various component, okay, associated with this test rig. So first component, that is impeller, then a volute casing, then suction pipe, then flow control valve, delivery pipe, priming valve, energy meter, voltage or a speed regulator. Okay, so we'll see one by one. Okay, so first part is impeller. Okay, so impeller is the one of the most important parameter, okay, in centrifugal pump. Basically depends on the application, we use the impeller. That is, the three types of impellers are used in centrifugal pump. Okay, so open impeller, semi open, and closed impeller. Okay, so next, that is volute casing. Okay, again, why we say this casing as volute casing, because at the inlet to outlet, the area of this casing gradually increases. Okay, so that's why the whatever the pressure from inlet to outlet, it will be increases, or we can say pressure head of this liquid is increases. Okay, that's why we provide a volute casing, because at the end of this the pump, we require a maximum pressure. Okay, with large discharge, then suction pipe. Okay, so you can see in this diagram, then flow control valve, we control the flow, or we control the discharge by using this valve. Okay, so if you regulate this valve, the pressure variation at the outlet will be getting, again, that from this outlet valve will take in the observations. Then energy meter for the to taking the input power. Okay, so next slide I will discuss the main procedure of energy meter, and then speed regulator to maintain the voltage, we regulate the speed. Okay, now this is the introduction of centrifugal pump. So basically the centrifugal pump, in commonly we use the volute pump. Okay, so in this type of pump, the fluid enters the pump at the center of a rotating impeller. The rotating impeller causes a rapid radial acceleration of the fluid from the eye of the impeller to the pumps of circumferential casing. This creates a vacuum at the center of the impeller, so resulting in a continual entry of more process fluid. The fluid exits through the pump, okay, with high pressure, okay. So at the center of the impeller, the vacuum is created. So because of this vacuum, okay, from outside of the pump, the atmosphere pressure is there, okay. So because of this pressure difference, the pump will lift the water and will get the desired result, okay. Now next observations. So apparatus required for this experiment, that is the centrifugal pump test rig, then stopwatch, meter scale, okay. Now specification, pump, the size of pump is 25-25 mm, then head is 11 meter, so that is the maximum head we have achieved by using this pump, okay. The speed of pump is 2900 rpm, then impeller diameter 99 mm, then output of this pump is 1 hp, means 1 horsepower, okay. Then transmission efficiency for this pump is 80%, then current required for this this 4 ampere, and voltage to 180 volt. Then area of the tank, okay, this 0.5 into 0.33 is in meter, okay, so keep in mind. Now what will be taking precautions during the practical, okay. So there should not be any contaminants in the water, because it will harmful for on our impeller. Then keep control valve and discharge valve open. So basically we'll check the water level on the impeller, that's why we require priming, okay. So why we prime? Because we neglect the air pockets from the suction pipe and impeller, so we'll get the desired pressure difference, okay. Then next, set the voltage regulator. So this is the test rig of centrifugal pump. So first of all, we start the pump by using this switch, okay. Then next we'll check the water level, okay. Now this is the priming valve. So before starting the pump, we have to check the whether priming is okay or not, okay. Then this is the voltage regulator, okay. We'll set the input power, okay. So by using this voltage meter, we set the speed, okay. So if you take any speed for so for the centrifugal pump, we are going to take two tests, that is constant speed test and variable speed test. So by using this dimmer stat, we can regulate the voltage, okay. So next, from this dimmer stat we set the speed, and from this motor we can take the speed of the, or we can say RPM of the pump, okay, from this shaft, okay. Now from this, this is the suction valve, okay. So after starting the pump, we take this suction pressure and then discharge pressure, and this is the flow control valve. So by using the, and this is the so this is flow control valve, and by using the this tank control valve, we take the discharge, and we'll take 10 centimeter rise water, and we'll take time taken for 10 centimeter rise, okay, and we'll get the discharge. So this is all about the so So now we'll take the actual trial, okay? So for to taking the actual trial for the constant speed, first of all we'll take about constant speed. So that the procedure becomes the prime the pump, close the delivery valve completely and start the motor. And then next, obtain the speed of the pump at some constant value by use of dimmer stat. Okay. Allow some time to settle the conditions and note down speed of the pump. Also note down the vacuum and pressure gauge readings. Then note down the time required for 10 flashes from this energy meter. Then note down time required for 10 cm or 100 mm rise of water. Then open delivery valve slightly and measure speed, which is remains constant, and pressure gauge reading and time for the discharge, and repeat above for different delivery opening valve. Okay. And procedure for variable speed. So first of all, prime the water. Prime the pump. Close the delivery valve completely and start the motor. Then keep the delivery valve open partially, say 50%, which is remains unchanged. By keeping dimmer stat position in constant speed, we does not rotate the dimmer stat. First we set the dimmer stat, then we does not check every time. But in variable speed, we continuously rotate the, or we can say, repeat the rotation of dimmer stat. So nearly maximum, measure the speed, measure the gauge reading, and time for 10 centimeter rise, and we'll take 10 flashes from this energy meter. So repeat this procedure 4 to 5 positions of dimmer stat and take the readings. So this is the block diagram of centrifugal pump. Okay, so we can see this is the supply tank, then collecting water. Then this is the panel of taking the readings of energy meter. Okay. Then this is the drain wall. So the gauge glass scale for to measure the 10 centimeter rise water. Now the centrifugal pump, motor, then gate wall. Okay. So this is the overall block diagram of centrifugal pump test rig. Now these are the observations. Okay. For constant speed, suppose first reading we have to taken about the speed of 1140 rpm. For that speed, the suction head is in meter. I'm taking directly meter of hg, not mm of hg. So for that we'll, for the simplicity of the calculation, so the suction head at the inlet of the pipe at 0.025 meter of hg, means mercury. Why we take is meter of hg, because it's a vacuum, so that's why we always measure the vacuum is in meter of hg. Then delivery head within kg per centimeter square, that is 0.25. then time required for d10 flashes is 1039.48, and time for 10 centimeter rise of water is 40. So repeat this procedure by using this flow control valve at the outlet, and we'll take these readings, okay, and we'll get the this observation table. Okay, so how to calculate the manometric head, then input power efficiency, we'll see. Okay, so this is the sample calculation for constant speed. The how to calculate total head, so total head is nothing but a manometric head. So h is equal to hs, means suction head plus delivery head, plus 0.61 is the friction losses associated with the suction pipe and delivery pipe. So from this manufacturing catalog we directly taken 0.61. okay, so now from this observation we'll get this pressure in terms of meter of hg. We have to convert into meter of water head. Okay, so by using this formula 13.6 into 10 raised to minus 3. So what is mean by 13.6? 13.6 is the specific gravity of the mercury. So multiply by this pressure, we'll get the whatever pressure in a meter of water, okay? Or we yes, meter of water. Now then again delivery pressure, again same, convert into the meter of water. So we'll get the 6.61 meter, this total head. So how to calculate actual discharge by using this continuity equation? So the actual discharge is nothing but area into some distance rise, okay? So we can say volume upon time, okay? So volume of the tank to the area, so area volume of the tank to the time required for the 10 centimeter rise. So that is, A is nothing but area of tank, Y is the 10 centimeter rise water level, and T is the time taken for 10 centimeter rise of water level in collecting tanks. So that is the 40 seconds for the first observation. Now so actual discharge is nothing but the 0.004125 meter cube per second. So how to calculate the input power? So because we have to find out the overall efficiency of this pump, so input power is required. So input power is from the energy meter. So the imperial formula is 3600 into N. N is nothing to, capital N is nothing but number of revolution of energy meter. So into transmission efficiency to the energy meter constant, okay, that is 3200 into time taken for N revolution, means 10 revolution of energy meter will taking the time. So 3600 into 10 into 0.8 divided by 3200 into 39.48. So we'll get the input power is 0.227 kilowatt, okay. Now how to calculate output power? For the calculating the output power, so output power is rho qgh upon 1000 in kilowatt. So rho gqh, okay, so 1000 get cancelled, so q rho qh will get the 0.0227 kilowatt. So the efficiency of the pump, that is nothing but output upon input. So whatever output, that is water power, and the input is our motor power, okay? So we'll get the efficiency for the first observation 9.95, approximately 10% for the first observation, okay? Now the result analysis from this calculation. So for the first observation, so manometric head becomes 6.61 by mistakenly I've written here 5.61. So the discharge becomes 0.004125. The input power is 0.227, the output power is 0.0226, and the efficiency is 9.95, okay? By using this table, okay, we plot the characteristics curve for the first step, that is constant speed test. So these are the characteristics curve, okay? So as we know, the these are the discharge versus head input power and efficiency, okay? So from the head and discharge curve, it seen that for given speed, as discharge increases, head partially, or we can say gradually, decreases. The maximum head developed is corresponding it to no discharge from the pump is called as a shut off head, okay? So so also for given discharge, greater the speed, higher the head, okay? Now next, from the input to the discharge curve, so power consumption increases, okay? We can say here's input speed of the pump is constant, okay? So that's why input power remains constant, okay? So discharge is gradually increases. Now the efficiency versus discharge curve, the speed of the as the discharge increases, power increases, therefore efficiency also increases. Okay, so from this discharge versus efficiency gap, you can see the proportionally the discharge of the and discharge and efficiency will go or increases. Okay, so these are the characteristic curve and its explanation. Okay, now a student will solve the various observations. Okay, for the batch one, we can take speed as 1000. Okay, and we'll get this observation table and solve the sample calculation and plot the graphs for this case. For batch 2, we can take this as a speed as a 1300 as a speed, constant speed, and we'll get this suction delivery time taken for 10 flashes and time for 10 centimeter rise of water. Okay, then next batch 3, we can take this constant speed as 1500, and this is the observations, and we can solve and plot the graphs on graph paper. Okay, now next we'll discuss about the second test, that is variable speed. Now for procedure for variable speed, so first of all, prime the pump, close the delivery valve completely and start the motor. So keep the delivery valve open partially, say 50%, which remains unchanged. By keeping the dimmer start position to nearly maximum, measure the speed, pressure gauge reading and time for 100 mm rise and 10 flashes, and repeat for 4 to 5 times of dimmer start and take the readings. Okay, so from this procedure we'll take this observations. So the speed becomes 1324, then suction head, that is 0.03, delivery head 0.3, time for 10 flashes 42, time for 10 centimeter rise 40, then for second, third, and so on. Okay, so by using this given values, okay, we'll find out the head efficiency. Okay, so by using this previous formulas, okay, we can directly find the, first of all, find the head by using the suction head plus delivery head plus friction losses, we'll get the manometric head. Then discharge by using the relation area into that height, that is y distance, or we can say volume of the tank to the time taken for the 10 centimeter rise, so we'll get the discharge. Then input power by using this empirical formula, okay, 3600 into the transmission efficiency, okay, into number of revolution of energy meter to the energy constant capital E 3200 into the time taken for 10 revolution. Okay, then output power, output power is nothing but rho qgh upon 1000. By using this formula, we'll get the power 0.02675, and the efficiency becomes 12.48, and the repeat this procedure for observation 2, 3 and 4, and we'll get this desired result. Okay, and again now we'll talk about the characteristics curve. Okay, so characteristic curve for this variable speed. Okay, so same, so first of all, the head discharge versus head, same, as head increases, discharge goes on, or we can say discharge is inversely proportional to the head. Okay, then discharge versus input power, okay, it will goes on in decreasing. Okay, so input power and discharge, these are the directly proportionals. Okay, now the head versus efficiency versus discharge, we'll get the the proportionality constant, or we can say proportionally increases. Okay, so means efficiency and discharge curve for given speed. Okay, this as the discharge increases, power increases, therefore efficiency also increases. Okay, so these are the characteristics curve. Okay, then for the your understanding, or we can say a student will solve the variable speed test by using these observations. So speed of the for batch 1 speed becomes 1000 1230 1460 1565. Okay, and for that speeds then suction delivery and time for 10 flashes and time for 10 centimeter rise is given. Okay, so we'll write down on your paper and solve the various result and plot this result on the graph. Okay, so for batch 2, so the observation becomes 1050 1170 1360 and 1465. Okay, and the suction delivery time for 10 centimeter flashes. Okay, time for 10 centimeter rise water. Okay, so it becomes like this, and same parallelly for batch 3. Okay, so these are the observations for variable speed. Okay, so you can write down on your paper. Okay, now the role of student. So first, do the calculations for constant speed and variable speed. Write the experiment on A4 size rolled pages as explained here. Draw the block diagram of experimental test trick on blank pages. Prepare observation table, result table, and plot the graph. Okay, so the experiment learning outcomes. Okay, so explain the student able to explain the practical relevance, significance, importance, and experimental procedure of centrifugal pump. Then analysis of characteristics of centrifugal pump. So thank you.